How's it going? I'm Scott Moss, and I've been an engineer for over a decade, since before there were full-stack frameworks. Today, I bring you how to build full-stack apps using Next.js V2. In this course, I'm gonna teach you about all the new features that React 18 introduces. I'm talking client components, server components, and how Next.js takes advantage of those things in such a beautiful way. File-based routing, dynamic routing, middleware, layouts. I had so much fun getting to know all the cool things about Next.js, and I can't wait to share them with you. If we just take a quick look at what we have here, it's not a complicated schema. I mean, it's going to be a pretty simple project task management app where we have a user, and the user has projects, and those projects have tasks. And that's mostly it. There's a lot of relationships between the three, but that's mostly it. So what we can do now is we can go ahead and create this user. So the first thing I'm going to do is make an ID and go through and you know, kind of get all the other stuff in there. So you can say model user. You can say this is an ID. It's a type of string. You can also do integer if you prefer and have your user IDs be numbers. I don't like that, so I'm going to say string. And then I'm going to say this is an ID. Like that. And then I can say default, and I'm going to use UUID. So this is just basically making the user IDs strings of type UUID. A UUID is a type of universally unique identifier. It's a formatted string that looks a certain way that's pretty much guaranteed to be unique. That's what UUID is. So I'm making my user IDs UUIDs. Say created at, which is going to be a date time, and it's going to default to now. And then I can say updated at, that's also going to be a date time, and then there's a special updated at. So we don't have to touch it. It just updates that field for us automatically whenever we touch this model. Okay. Then the user can have an email, which is going to be a type string. First name, which is also a string. A last name. We have a password. Password. That's a string. What else do we have on here? Projects and tasks. Well, we'll get to that in a minute when we do relations. So for user, for the most part, that's pretty good. So then we'll keep it moving. And we'll say model project. And we can just copy these first three things here, put them here. Everything's going to have an ID, a created at, and updated at. So we just put that there. And a project has a name. That's a string. What else would a project have? It might have like a status. Oh, no, we have the owner stuff. Yeah, so a project will also have who owns the project, like who does it belong to. If we don't have this, when we do a query, we won't know what project belongs to the user that signed in. We'll just be getting random people's projects. So we can say owner ID like this, and that's going to be a string. And then we can say owner is going to be a user like that. And then we can say it's going to have a relation with these fields of owner ID that maps to the reference on the user's ID, like that. And it's still going to throw me this little error here. Basically, what this is saying is, I want to have an owner field whose type is user, and it's related to a user ID, and it maps to the owner ID over here. So this owner ID is going to map to the ID on the user. And it's freaking out right now. It's like, hey, you got to go to the other side of this relationship and add something there. And we could do that, but I'm really lazy, so I'm going to do it the lazy way. You can just run npx prisma format, and it'll do it for you. So I did that, and you can see right here, it added project. But I'm going to lowercase that and call it projects plural, because it's an array of projects. It's a one-to-many relationship, so I'm just going to change that to projects and keep it the type project array. We should think about how our page is loading up right now. We have a few things on here. So we have this. It's taking forever to load because of the delay. So that delay, then we have this component coming in. we kind of want to handle this delay because we're about to add this task card on here, and that's going to have another requirement for data fetching. Although it's not blocking the page like projects is, it's going to be more how the greeting card is. It'll just render when it gets there. But that delay right there, that strong delay while it's loading, right here, this one. Yes, we see the projects here because it's cached, but it won't always be there. It's just because it's cached and I'm on localhost and whatnot. So we should probably set up a loader for this page. So what we'll do is we'll go to app, dashboard, and then home. Right next to page, we can make a loader or loading.tsx. So all this is going to be is just your classic loader, whatever you want to put, a spinner, the word loading, doesn't matter. I did make one for us, and we could talk about it, but it's mostly just using Tailwind, so I'm just going to paste it in, and it's just a loader. It's just using the animate spin on a circle with a dash border sitting in a card. That's all it is. It's nothing crazy. So we have that now, and for free, if we just load up our page, we should see a loader like that now. Right? That's because the projects were loading in. And the projects has like a 2 second delay or whatever delay I put on the projects, I forgot. But that's why you see that. And then when we get in, we see the greetings take 4 or 5 seconds to load in because I put the delay on that. Right? So you literally get granular control over what's loading and how it's loading and what's blocking and what's not blocking. And then for the task page, I guess forgot to put a slide for it in here because we could just add it to the project. It's nothing really special. So what we'll do is just go to the home page, scroll down to where it says task here, get rid of that, and you could just bring in the task card. Did I export mine? I forgot to export mine. There we go. You just bring that in, hit save, and see if anything broke. Boom, there we go. Now we got a task card. So what we're gonna do next is get this project page working. So when you click on the project, it actually goes to the project page where you can see the task. So let's do that, because right now it'll just 404 if I, or whatever that is, it'll do that. So let's fix that. So for the project page, and this is why I was saying we had to make the task card flexible, because the project page is going to be responsible for getting its own project based off the ID of the URL. And if we're already getting a project, we might as well just put include task true. So if we're going to reuse the task card, the project is already getting its own task. Why do we need the task card to get the task again? And it's not even getting all of them, it's only getting like the first five. So that's why I extended the task card to take in task as a prop, so it could either give it a list of tasks, or it'll go get the first five by default. So that's why we did that. So let's go make this. So we'll go into, don't quit. We'll go to dashboard, project, ID, page. And we'll just make our stuff in here. So export, default, async, function. This will be the project page. There we go. We need to get data. That's going to be async. Got to see if this is the user first, like always. So we're going to await get user from cookie. What cookies? This is going to take an ID. It's going to be a project ID. Then we can say const project equals await db dot project dot find unique, or is it find first? Yeah, it's find first. It's not a unique index. find the first one where the ID is going to be ID and the owner is going to be user.id or owner ID. Sorry, it's user ID. And then we just want to include all of our tasks. From there, we're going to just return the project. You can destructure it if you want to. You can do whatever. There's no wrong or right there. Cool. We got that. Now, because this page is a dynamic page, as in it is a its parent folder has brackets around it, that's what makes this a dynamic page, will automatically get passed params. Every page that's a page inside of a folder like this is going to get params. So we can say const project equals await get data, and we can pass an ID, which will be params dot whatever your folder name is. In our case, it's ID. And then from there, it's really just some basic JSX. Just going to bring in my task card. There we go. Task card. Yeah, okay. Yeah, so you're going to get a TypeScript type here because it doesn't know how to handle components that return promises yet. There's a fix for it. There's like a comment you can put in here for TypeScript to ignore this, but it's fine. And then these are just tripping because project might be null and we're not handling it. We're just not handling everything, which is fine. Okay, any questions on this? Let's try it out. So if we go here, quick little refresh, see our 60 frames per second spinner, click on one of these projects, boom. Got a project with all the tasks.